Assalamu alaikum. Today I'm here. Today's my topic is Ulam Iqbal. Open page number 37. Look at here first paragraph. Ulama Muhammad Iqbal, the poet of the East, was born in Sialkot, a town in the Punjab, on 9th November 1877. He received his early education in his home town. In 1895, he went to Government College, Lahore. He passed his MA in 1899 from the University of the Punjab. In the same year, he was appointed professor of Arabic at the Oriental College, Lahore. He held this job till 1905. In that year, he left for England for higher studies. In London, he received a law degree in 1908. He was awarded a degree of PhD by Minute University for his work on Persian philosophy. That is why he is also known as Dr. Muhammad Iqbal. I'm going to read second paragraph. Ulama Iqbal is generally known as a great poet. He was no doubt a great poet, but poetry was only one of his many accomplishments. He was well-versed in philosophy, both Eastern and Western. He point out the defects in some of the philosophical system of the West. He devote a great part of his life to the study of Islam. He also took an active part in politics. He worked for the Muslim of South Asia with great courage. He was elected a member of the Punjab Legislative Council in 1926. He held that office till 1929. He did not seek re-election. He was elected president of the Punjab branch of the All India Muslim League and held that post till his death. In 1930, he preferred over the Allahabad meeting of the All India Muslim League. It was on this historic occasion that he made a definite demand for a separate Muslim state in South Asia. In his presidential address, Dr. Iqbal said, India is India is continent. Open page number 38. Of human groups belonging to different races, speaking different languages and believing in different religions, their behavior is not governed by common race feeling. These groups are all separate nations. The principle of European democracy cannot be applied to India without recognizing the fact of different groups. The Muslim demand to create a Muslim India within India is in no way without justice. For my part, I would like to go one step forward. I would like to see the Punjab, Northwest Frontier Province, Sindh and Balochistan united under a single Muslim state. The Muslims are anxious to have a separate state because they fear the Hindu majority, which they believe will not allow Muslims to develop freely. This demand shocked both the Hindus and the British alike. They both opposed it. This was the first time that a demand was made for a separate Indian Muslim state. Dr. Iqbal did not stop at this. All his efforts were now direct towards the achievement of this goal. In May 1937, Dr. Iqbal wrote a letter to Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah. In this lecture, he discussed in detail the problem of the Indian Muslims. He once again advised that only the creation of a separate Muslim state could solve this problem and said to the Qaid, "Don't you think that the time to such a demand has already arrived?" On 21st June 1937, he again wrote to the Qaid-e-Azam a separate federal state of Muslim provinces. Formed on the lines I have proposed is the only way by which we can have a peaceful India and save Muslims from the rule of non-Muslims. Now class, inshallah, remaining part of this unit, I will read my next lecture. Inshallah, your homework is this unit read again in your home. I am also giving worksheet in this unit. And inshallah, I will explain in Urdu this unit in my next video. Allah Hafiz.